Oh my God, tunnel. G'day, I'm Mark from Self-Sufficient Me, and in this video, I want to show you guys how I built this fantastic gourd tunnel. You know, for years, I've been wanting to build a tunnel like this, because in our summer heat, a lot of traditional vegetables can't handle it. You can't handle the heat. But gourds, they love the heat. So I finally got around to building one. Let's get into it. Now this is important. Right from the start, I want to make it crystal clear that I'm no carpenter, if it isn't obvious already. But the purpose of this video is not to say this is the best way to build a gourd tunnel. No, the purpose of the video is to show you how I built one, and then you can hopefully glean some ideas from that and build one of your own, likely a lot better even. Keep in mind that this is a retrofit build, and because this is a retrofit of an existing garden bed and trellis, it's likely different to what I might build if I was starting from scratch. For example, I might have started the Rio mesh sheeting higher up at the top here and kept it in one piece and just bent it over like a dome rather than patchwork together like I have done in this trellis build, or use several thin pre-stamped raised beds from Birdies side by side with Rio mesh over the top, and that would have saved a heap of build time. I tried to use as much recycled materials as possible, such as wood salvaged from our front stairs renovation, old timber sleepers, and Rio trellis from the front garden bed refurbishment. And of course, the main Rio mesh used in this project was actually part of an existing tomato trellis I made about 10 years ago, which was a really simple design whereby several segments of Rio mesh was held in place with star pickets. Basically, the main materials used in this gourd tunnel trellis build were recycled timber, hardwood decking boards, corrugated iron sheeting, recycled and new Rio mesh, galvanized threaded rod, wire, some PVC piping, and lots of roofing screws. The main tools used were a cordless drill, nibbler attachment, cordless handsaw, circular saw, mattock, hammer, and hole punch. In case you don't know, I'm a huge fan of raised bed gardening because it's so much easier and convenient. One of the bugbears I had with my previous trellis build was the low garden beds at a single sleeper high. We were always bending over to weed or plant, and grasses found it easy to invade the growing space. I wanted to raise these beds to at least waist high and make them no wider than arm's length so all the growing space could be easily accessed from one side. I started with a reasonably square base, 4 by 2.4 meter sleepers long, making the build 9.6 meters overall in length and just under 2 feet wide, or about 70 centimeters. You wouldn't necessarily have to have a sleeper base like I did, but it made seating the iron sheets easier and helped with positioning of the posts. If I didn't have this base here, I would have just done it the old way, leveled it off like I did in the beginning actually to make these beds, and used a string line to get it nicely squared off before I started just putting the posts in and then the corrugated iron. I initially positioned the posts and dug them in at the ends of each piece of iron sheeting, but then I added a smaller center post for each sheet to give it better strength and help prevent bow out later when the beds were filled with soil. The iron sheeting was fixed to the posts with 45mm roofing screws, and I used a hole punch to make screwing through the sheets easier. To cut the iron for the sides, I used a nibbler attachment on my drill because the sheeting was too thick to cut with tin snips. As extra reinforcement to prevent the beds from bowing out too much, I attached 2 galvanized threaded rods made to fit in the center of both long beds, about a third of the way from the bottom. Then the base of the beds were lined first with garden waste, such as leaves and branches. If you want to know more about this method and exactly what I'm talking about, it's called the Hugel culture method, and I've done a video on it, so check it out after this video. Link up here and in the description. Then I topped with garden soil from a landscaping supplies place. Once the beds were filled, I leveled off the posts with a handsaw and then screwed on some decking wood for a top handrail. The mesh roof was next to go on by laying pre-cut segments over the top of the existing mesh framework and then wiring it securely into place. I didn't have enough recycled mesh, so I purchased some more from a concreting retailer. I got the young fella to cut the mesh into manageable sizes at the shop, and that saved me a bit of time as well. I then prepared the garden beds for planting by topping the soil with compost, some organic fertilizer, and loosened hay mulch. There will always be sinkage in a raised bed like this, and that's normal. At the end of the growing season, what I'll generally do is top these beds up because you will often get some sinkage. Bulk them up with a little bit of extra compost, a whole bunch of mulch on top, maybe some fertilizer, a bit of lime possibly, and that will set those beds up nicely for the next coming season. And then this is what is called no dig gardening. Finally, to get a bit of extra height out of the tunnel roof and give it some extra support for when the vines started growing over it, I installed several posts made from segmented PVC pipe with a groove cut in the top. This makes for easy installation and removal if required for mowing, etc., or general maintenance. I'm new to gourd growing, so I'm keen to learn as much as I can about this vegetable. That's why I sowed several different varieties. I also planted other things like beans and even a tomato, which was already late in season, but it grew okay anyway. Some of the crops we planted are still establishing, and I'll endeavour to share them with you in one way or another once we get some worthwhile produce. We've been making gourd curries and bakes, finding the best ways to eat them. Some are bitter and we're not too fond of them, but most are sweetly delicious, and we're having a lot of fun experimenting with them all. There are lots of gourd varieties to grow. And not only that, there are plenty of other vegetables too that love growing over this type of structure. So I'm pretty confident this gourd tunnel is going to get plenty of use in the years to come. You may have also noticed that I underplanted some carrots and spring onions, and they're doing all right, especially in places where they can get a little more sun. I'm sure we'll find all sorts of ways to get the best out of this design and make it as productive as possible. Overall, a project like this will cost about $1,200 to build and fill with soil, especially if you buy all the materials new. The iron sheeting alone costs $600 because I got it new and it's good quality thicker gauge. But this raised bed tunnel is extreme at 20 meters long if you count both beds, so not everyone will make one this big unless you're a keen grow your own food family like us, and then it's a good investment. Well, I reckon anyway. I'm rapt at how this project turned out. Yes, it's far from perfect. However, it is strong and sturdy and does the job of growing gourds perfectly. I have a feeling this won't be the last time you see this gourd tunnel in action on Self-Sufficient Me. So watch this space. I hope this video has given you some insight on gourd growing and in particular trellis making for growing gourds. If you like this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and share it around because that helps my channel heaps. If you've got any questions or comments in general you'd like to make, whack them down in the comments section below. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye for now.